Welcome to this Hatha yoga practice for posterior chain power. Today we are going to be exploring some of my favorite asanas that really help us complement the sedentary lifestyle that some of us have grown to love so much. When you're ready, we will begin today's practice lying down in supine bound angle, Supta Baddha Konasana. Join the soles of the feet together, pressing into the blade edges of your feet as you open your knees and your hips out to the side. You might like to place one palm on the belly and the other on the heart space. Perhaps closing your eyes feels right for you today. Begin to soften the facial features. Relax the muscles around the heart space and chest. Allow the shoulders to melt into the earth. Soften the belly, relax the hips and the outer glutes. You might like to take this opportunity to thank yourself for carving out the time and space to nurture your well-being. Gently guide your awareness towards the breath. Notice the duration of each inhalation and of each exhalation. Offer yourself one more nourishing breath in this hip opener. On your next inhalation, mindfully return your arms the length of the body. Close off the hip joints as you return the soles of your feet to the earth. From here we'll come up into our bridge lift. On your exhalation, engage the glutes, raise the lower back and the pelvis. Press into the big toe mounds to help you engage the inner thighs. Begin to feel the activation along the back of your legs. And mindfully lower down one vertebra at a time. On your next exhalation, rise up to your bridge, Setu Bandha Sarvangasana. Option to stay here. We'll now place your palms underneath your sacrum, supporting the pelvis. Guide your left knee in towards the chest. And if you like, begin to extend your leg skywards. Flex your foot and really drive your left heel towards the sky. Engaging the muscles along the back of your right leg and the glutes. Stabilize the pelvis. And mindfully lower your foot down. Inhale. And on your next exhalation, extend your right leg. Continue to raise your pelvis whilst knitting the ribs together. So so we're not puffing up the rib cage here. Soften the face and the jaw. Relax the throats. One mindful breath here. Mindfully lower your right leg onto the earth. Release the arms. Inhale. And on your exhalation, gently lower down. Soften the glutes and the muscles along the back body. On your next exhalation, press into the feet, rise up, bridge pose. And for this variation, if you like, you can interlace your fingers together behind your back. Keep pressing your palms into the earth. And on your exhalation, straighten your left leg skywards, this time pointing the toes. Feeling a nice stretch for the front of your ankle. Breathing into any regions of sensation. Mindfully return your left foot to the earth, stabilize the pelvis, swap the cross of your hands. On your next exhalation, extend your right leg and breathe. Mindfully release, uncross your arms, and roll your pelvis back down onto the mat. Cross your right ankle atop of your left thigh, flex your right foot, and guide your left knee in towards the chest, interlacing your fingers either around your shin or the underside of your thigh. Continue to press your right knee away from the body to help you deepen this outer hip stretch. You might like to circle the left foot and the left ankle. Now let's find our supine cow face pose. Crossing the right knee in front of the left knee. Grabbing a hold of the blade edges of your feet as you guide your legs away from the midline. Softening the upper body. Notice the sensation along the outer hips. Gently uncross your legs, return both soles of the feet to the earth, relax your arms, One breath here. Now cross your left ankle atop of your right thigh as we find our supine pigeon pose with the other leg, Supta Kapotasana. While we are using our hands and our arms to support us in this posture, see if you can soften into the upper limbs. You might like to circle your right foot. Now let's find our supine cow face pose, Supta Gomukhasana. Guiding your thighs, your knees in towards the chest as you pull your feet out away from the body. Gently uncross the legs. Keep your right foot on the earth. Interlace your fingers behind your left thigh. On your inhalation, begin to extend your legs skywards. Exhale mindfully, rebend, and again. Inhale to lift. Exhale to lower. On your next inhalation, keep your leg extended. You might like to lower your right leg down onto the earth. Again, you might like to find some movement with your left foot. You might notice a deep stretch for the outer regions of your calf muscle, perhaps along the hamstrings. From here, bending your left knee, and with the support of your right hand, guide your knee across the body as we come into a supine spinal twist. Perhaps turning your gaze to the left. Letting go. Mindfully return to center. We'll find our leg movements with our right leg. So with your hands behind your thigh, on your inhalation, straighten your leg. Exhale to bend, and again. Inhale, find length, soften the upper body. Exhale to lower. If it feels right for you, keep your right leg straightened and begin to extend your left leg towards the mat. Know that you can always adjust the positioning of your hands along your leg for more or less of a stretch. Rebend the knee and let's find our supine spinal twist, Supta Ardha Matsyendrasana. Doing your best to keep both shoulders on the mat, relaxing the chest and the belly, On your inhalation, return to center. Guide both knees in towards the chest. Let's find a few gentle spinal rolls, rolling between the sacrum and the shoulder blades. And when you're ready, rising up into our boat pose, Navasana. Shins are parallel to the earth, extending your arms out in front. If you'd like to intensify this, you can begin to extend your knees, engage the thigh muscles, the core. Continue to lengthen the spine. Roll the shoulders down away from the ears. And gently release. Let's come into our tabletop position. We'll find a few rounds of our traditional cat and cow, Marijasana Bhutilasana. With every inhalation, open the chest. And with every exhalation, curl and round the spine. Return your spine to a neutral alignment. Tuck your left toes under, and on your exhalation, extend your left leg back, float it to hip height, engage your glutes. On your inhalation, reach your right arm up, bird dog, Dandayamana Bhamanasana. In this posture, we want to stabilize the pelvis and the shoulder girdle whilst reaching our limbs out in opposite directions. Mindfully return to tabletop. And on your next exhalation, extend your right leg, engage the glutes. Continue to gaze towards the mat, lengthening the back of your neck. With every exhalation, think about guiding your belly button towards the spine. Mindfully release. Tuck both toes under. Walk your hands out in front slightly, and on your exhalation, press up into downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. You might like to take a moment here to move the legs, bend your knees, shake the hips from side to side. Really honor what your body would like for today. On your next exhalation, float your left leg up three-legged dog, engage your glutes, square off the hips. Notice the deep stretch along the back of your right leg, perhaps your calf muscle. Continue to press firmly into the left palm and the left fingertips to help you stabilize the torso. Activate the shoulders. Gently return your left foot to the mat, inhale. On your exhalation, raise your right leg, three-legged dog, Ekapada Adho Mukha Svanasana. Mindfully return your right foot to the earth. Lower your knees down, point the toes, and come to rest in child's pose, balasana. Giving yourself permission to find softness. Offer yourself one more mindful breath here. When you feel ready, press into your palms and gently rise up. Roll the shoulders back and down. Now let's come to take a seat on our glutes. Place the feet on the mat, hip-width distance apart. Palms behind your back, fingers splayed out to the side. On your exhalation, drive into your feet and your hands rise up into our reverse tabletop. Engage the glutes and the core muscles. Continue to raise the pelvis skywards. Press firmly into the big toes to help you engage the inner seams of your thighs. Find an inhalation here. And on your exhalation, gently lower your glutes down onto the earth. Elevate the torso. Roll the shoulders back and down. Perhaps take a moment to circle out the wrists, shake out your hands. You can re-perform that exercise. Otherwise, we'll come into a full expression of our Bhujangasana, reverse plank. With this variation, extend your legs, press into your heels and your palms, and on your inhalation, rise up. Again, we want to activate the glutes here. Continue to shine your heart up towards the universe. If it's in your practice, you might like to relax your head and gaze behind you. Take one more mindful breath here. And gently lower down, hold on. From here, we'll come into a forward fold, Paschimottanasana. If you have tight hamstrings, you can definitely start off with bent knees. Rest your belly atop of your thighs. And if you feel okay there, begin to straighten your legs. Maybe lower your forehead down towards your shin. You can either flex, point, or relax your feet here. Soften into the upper body. Notice the sensations along the back of your legs. Breathe. Allow yourself to rise up in your own time. From here, let's come into double pigeon or firelog pose. cross one shin atop of the other, aligning your knees and your ankles, flexing your feet. Option to stay upright or hinge forwards. Reach your arms out in front. Melt your upper body down towards the earth. This can be a really intense stretch for the outer glutes and the outer hips. So really honor what is unfolding for you with a tender heart and loving compassion. Mindfully walk your hands in towards the body. Elevate the torso, roll the shoulders back and down. Swap the cross of your legs, and we'll again find our fire log pose with the opposite shin on top. Soften into this posture and breathe. In your own rhythm, rise up, roll the shoulders back and down, and come to take a seat in a comfortable position. Let's find a nice side bend, lowering one arm to one side, and swapping sides. Inhale through center. Exhale, side bend once more. Noticing the beautiful opening for your waist. Return to a seated position. Roll the shoulders back and down. Rest your palms atop of your lap. You might like to close the eyes here. Gift yourself this space to check in with your experience. Notice how the body is feeling. Perhaps notice if there are any differing sensations compared to when we started our practice. Maybe you notice nothing at all, and recognize that that is okay as well. Allow the breath to be a container for your experience. Let us round off today's practice with three nourishing breaths. Inhaling through the nostrils. And exhaling, letting go. Twice more. On your next inhalation, Begin to reach your arms skywards, stretch the torso. And on your exhalation, guide your palms towards your heart center. We'll do that again. Inhale to rise. Exhale, hands towards your heart. And again. Inhale, lifts. Call upon empowering energy. Exhale, guide this energy in towards your heart. If you'd like to join us, we will finish today's practice with the mantra Om. Inhale to prepare. Om. Namaste. Thank you so much for joining this Hatha yoga practice. If you liked this video, feel free to give it a thumbs up, leave a comment down below, and subscribe to this channel to really support the continuation of free and accessible yoga.